Welcome to Masjid Agung Surakarta Central Java, a historical heritage which used to be a center of Islamic development centuries ago. Talking about history, this place has a clock which tells you about prayer time based on the sunlight.
The unique clock name is Tiwa, which referred to entering the prayer time in Arabian language. While Javanese people call it Bencet since this clock was planted inside the soil. Istiwa clock was placed at the front part of Surakarta Great Mosque since its first appearance in 1855. It became a guidance of prayer time when Pakubuwana VIII ruled Surakarta Palace.
Dulu untuk menentukan waktu sholat itu belum ada jam seperti sekarang penunjuknya. Jadi para ulama keraton ini berpedoman dengan hadis Rasulullah bahwa waktu sholat itu ada waktu-waktu sendiri, terutama yang berkaitan dengan matahari. Kalau dilihat dengan bayangan dan menitanya itu akurat, cuma kan sekarang Kementerian Agama ini memberi waktu dimundurkan sekitar 5 menit. Nah, tapi insya Allah sudah akurat, sudah pernah dilihat, diverifikasi oleh lembaga Falakiyah, Ru'yat dan Hisab Kementerian Agama.
Reading Istiwa clock is not that difficult. You only need to see on which number the shadow from the sun fell and the sunken vessel. Since the clock relied on the sunlight, its usage is more effective when determining Zuhur and Asar prayer time. But nothing will come out if the sky is cloudy. Passing by different generations, Istiwa clock stood tall at Surakarta Great Mosque. The mosque might not look for the precise prayer time on this clock nowadays. Yet people still showed curiosity, making the mosque committee place an information sign beside the clock and plastic case as a protection.
Ini kan benda cagar budaya yang ada di Masjid Agung kan tidak boleh dihilangkan supaya nanti mas anak-anak yang atau keturunan yang akan datang bisa mengetahui sejarah lengkap Masjid Agung ini dari raja peraja dari Pakubuwana ketiga sampai 10 ini.
Masjid Agung Surakarta was integral part of Solo. Established during Pakubuwana II ruling period between 1745 to 1749. This mosque became a part of the city development alongside the palace and the market, which located near each other. Andira Putri and Dian Merdekawati for See Today.